Hello, how's everybody doing tonight? This is Dwayne Allen, and I'm here to do a little comparison of a couple guitars that I have. Recently, someone commented on one of my gear videos and had asked me to do a comparison between a fully hollow body guitar and a semi-hollow body, and I thought, that's a great idea. I never thought of doing that. It seems like a simple enough thing to do, but never occurred to me. I do a lot of reviews for Collings guitars because they're my favorite guitar company, and I'm very blessed that I have a few of them. So I'm gonna do a comparison of two of my Collings guitars that I love to play. These are the guitars that I tend to play the most a lot lately. I tend to play a lot of jazz music, so these guitars are great for that. So let me turn the amp down. So let's talk about each guitar real briefly, and I'll compare them, and you'll get to hear what they sound like. Some of you may not have a lot of experience with hollow bodies or semi-hollows, so maybe this might be some new information for all of you who are listening and watching. So this guitar here, we'll do this one first. This is a Collings Eastside LC Deluxe. The deluxe just means it's got more bling, but basically it's an Eastside LC. LC means laminate construction. So if you notice, this is actually a fully hollow guitar, which means that there's no center block down the middle. So it's fully hollow inside, okay? It's a beautiful work of art guitar. I'm so blessed to have it. This is what it looks like. And like I said, there's no center block. It is laminate construction, which means that it's basically laminated maple top, back, and sides. And as opposed to a spruce top arch top, like an L5 or something like that, spruce top is what you have on an acoustic guitar. So an L5 has a spruce top. And a lot of the times those guitars are called carved tops because they're all solid wood. There's no laminates. Those guitars tend to be much louder acoustically than a laminate guitar. But those guitars will feed back quicker and easier. So when Gibson started making laminate guitars in the 50s and stuff, they were trying to make guitars that were meant to be played electric so that they didn't feed back, okay? So if you listen to this guitar, it actually has a really good acoustic sound. It's kind of Collings' take somewhat on a Gibson ES-175. I had a 175 for a while and it was a great guitar. But this sounds different. This sounds much more acoustic than the 175 does, actually. So you can play this guitar. You can play it acoustically and it sounds great. I want to play both of these guitars acoustically so you can hear the difference, and then I'll plug them in. So this is what a laminate plywood, another name for laminated maple, plywood, laminated maple, archtop guitar, this is what it would sound like. Although, like I said, this guitar has a great acoustic sound compared to most laminate guitars. Alright, so that's what that guitar sounds like. This is one of my other favorite guitars, a Collings Soco 16 LC. And this is Collings' closest guitar to what a 335, Gibson ES-335 would be. Collings has another guitar called an I-35 LC, which I also have one. That one looks like a 335, but this one sounds more like a 335 because it's got the 16-inch body. So the I-35 is a 15-inch, so it's a little smaller, so it sounds a little different. This one, another beauty, but this one is a semi-hollow, so there's a block of wood going down the middle inside the guitar, and that's what Gibson came up with in the 50s also, and it allows you to play a guitar that sounds somewhat hollow, but you can play it through a loud amp and it's not going to feed back because of the wood in the middle. not a bad acoustic sound for semi-hollow. But you can tell there's a difference, right? The other one's definitely louder. One thing about any of the Collings hollow body guitars is that they just have a beautiful, clear sound. You can hear the whole sound spectrum, lows, mids, and highs. Gibsons tend to sound more in the mids. That's what they're famous for. And it's a cool sound. You know, 335s are awesome. You know, 175s are awesome. It's just Collings tend to have a little bit more definition, okay? So let me plug this one in first, play it through an amp for a moment, and then I'll play the hollow body through my amp for a moment, and then you guys get to see what they sound like through an amp. I'm just playing through my deluxe reverb. So I'm gonna keep it mostly on the neck pickup, because the other guitar, that's all it has is a neck pickup. So if I put on the treble pickup, it's gonna sound totally different. So you're gonna get a nice dark sound. Body guitar, when you have the wood down the middle, it has more sustain. It really rings a lot longer. So I love these types of guitars, because people often ask me, what do you prefer, a fully hollow or a semi-hollow? And it depends. If I'm playing with a group, like with a drummer, with a trio, quartet, or whatever, I like the semi-hollow. I like the sustain that I get, and sometimes I'll use overdrive. Okay. So you can really hear it sustain. So that's the sound you're gonna get. That being said, this guitar gets a really good jazz sound. So I do lots of jazz gigs with this, and it sounds fantastic for that. I got my Tube Screamer hooked up. I'm just gonna play just for a moment with a little bit of overdrive, just so you can see how well this guitar works with overdrive and how the other one's not gonna work that great with overdrive. So here we go. So playing. Just so it's apples to apples. Not playing very loud, but it's not even close to feeding back. So that's what this guitar sounds like, clean and with overdrive. And then let me pull out Eastside LC. I should have had a couple guitar stands set up, but that's not how I roll. Real quick. So this guitar is plugged in now. Hollow bodies also have a much more percussive sound. They don't ring as long. They don't have the sustain that a semi-hollow has. See, it kind of dies off quicker. Doesn't last as long. But that percussive kind of a sound really makes it swing, though. Like if you're doing the Freddie Green. Really has that percussive kick. Like whenever I play jazz on these guitars, I just makes me want to play bebop, because it's just got that percussive thing, you know? I don't even messing around. You can dig in harder and it's got that kind of punch to it, you know. Messing around, but so gives you an idea that this guitar has a lot more punch and more of a percussive sound. Now I'm going to kick in the overdrive. I don't know how well it's going to work out, but these types of guitars I don't really think are made for playing loud with overdrive. That's working okay. I should also mention I have 12s on this guitar and 11s on that guitar, so it's a little harder to bend on this guitar. Sounds okay with distortion, but I'm not playing loud at all. I'm in my room. If we were on a gig, it'd be going woo, be feeding back pretty bad. So. Sounds pretty good for right now, but definitely not what I would say what that guitar is made for. So I hope you guys got something out of that video. Just wanted to compare, you know, what a semi-hollow compared to hollow body sounds like. And those are a couple examples that I have. I'm sure somebody else is out there comparing like a 335 to a 175. I think those two guitars would be closer together in sound because the 175 is not as acoustic sounding as the Eastside is. So I bet you if you played through an amp, it'd be closer, I think, in sound than these two. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed that. If you enjoyed the little review, please hit subscribe. And thanks so much for listening. Have a great night.